discuss the steps of strategic human resource management, the steps that are followed by the strategic human resource manager. The first one is develop a thorough understanding of company's objectives, because we are basing all of our efforts of HRM in integration in accordance with the objective of the organization. So first we have to understand what are the objectives of the organization. Without understanding the goals, the objectives of the organization, we cannot start our organization HR activities. We cannot make any plans for our HR activities until and unless we understand, we have a thorough understanding of what are the objectives of the organization. Okay, so the next one is evaluate HR capabilities. So what are the, the internal analysis has to happen. What are your HR capabilities right now? What human resource competency, what capabilities of human resource, skills of human resource do you have in your organization? So first we are deciding what are the objectives. We are understanding what are the objectives of the organization. Where is the desired position of the organization? Where does the organization position itself in a desired form? Okay, so we are first analyzing the objectives of the organization, the desired position of the organization in future. Accordingly, we are now, second step is, we are now, this competency mapping is happening, internal scanning of the organization is happening, okay? Now, internal scanning of the organization means what? Internal scanning of the organization means that we are scanning the current employees of the organization. We are evaluating the competency, the capabilities, the skills of the current people of our organization. Okay, so this is the second thing we are doing. Why we are doing it? So that further steps can be taken. Further steps as in, first we have to see objectives. We have understood what are the objectives of the organization. Now we have to see whether the current employees are capable enough of achieving those objectives or not. If the current employees are capable of achieving the desired objectives, the desired position of the organization, then our work becomes simple. But if not, then we have to plan further of how we are going to equip our organization with people capable enough, competent enough to achieve those objectives. Okay, the third point is analyze your current HR capacity in light of your goals. Okay, now we are moving step by step. It is a systematic process. What we are doing is, first we are understanding the objectives of the organization. Okay, we have understood the objectives of the organization. Second, we are doing an internal scanning, an internal competency scanning, capability scanning. What kind of people do we have in our organization? Third, we are now attaching the people that we are having in our organization and what are the objectives of the organization. So we are scanning, we are checking, we are analyzing what is our current HR position and can our current HR position achieve the desired goals of the organization or not. Okay, next is estimate company's future requirements. Now what you are doing is you are estimating, if not, that means if the HR of your organization is not capable enough, is not competent enough, lacks skills for achieving the organizational objectives, now you have to estimate company's HR future HR requirements. Like what is the vision of your company, what is the mission of your company, okay? So where how your company is moving, and with that movement how the people that you require will differ. Okay, so you have to estimate the future requirements of your HR also. So with that future requirements, you have to analyze what will be the demand of HR in your organization, what kind of people will be required in your organization, and from where are you going to acquire these people. Okay, so then you are also deciding where what will be the supply of your organization for the people of the people that are competent enough to meet the organizational goals and requirements. Okay, so demand is forecasted for the future of your organization, the future goals of your organization. You are seeing what kind of people will be required, what competencies will be required, what skills will be required, and you are also forecasting the supply. That means from where are you going to get these people. The next point is determine the tools required for employees to complete the job. The tools here are the skills, the competencies, okay, the training, the education required by your employees to complete the job given to them. So you also have to determine what are the tools required by them. By tools we mean what are the competencies required, what are the skills required, what are the technology required, what other things that they require to complete a job. And it is, as an HR manager of the organization, it is your responsibility to provide them with all those tools. If they are lacking any skill, you have to provide them training. If they are lacking a system, you have to provide them with a system. If they require anything else, you have to provide them with all the tools that are required for completing a job. Next is implement the human resource management strategy. So after all these steps that you have taken, you after the planning of what a human resource are required, what training is required, what competency is required, what kind of people are required even in future to meet future goals of your organization, whatever strategies you have made for HR of your organization, implement that strategy, make it work, because only planning is not going to help achieve organizational goals, right? You have to implement the strategy. Now implementing the strategy means now you are performing what you have planned, performing all the things that you the strategies that you have made. Okay, and then after implementation, the last step that covers SHRM, that completes SHRM, is evaluation of your strategy and then taking corrective actions. Suppose you have implemented the HR strategy, okay, you have made a plan, you have made strategies of how you're going to hire people, what training, what competency, what skills, what number of people, what kind of people are required in your organization to fulfill the desired goal of the organization. You have planned it, you have implemented it, okay, you have hired people, you have motivated people, you have trained people according to them, that strategy, according to the organizational goal. But still you're still lacking something, you're still not able to achieve, you're still not able to integrate the departments, you're still not able to coordinate effectively with the departments. So there is some fault in your strategy, there needs to be some correction made in your strategy. So evaluate your strategy, whether it is fulfilling the task or not, whether it is fulfilling for what it was made or not, whether the organizational goals are being met or not. Okay, so you evaluate the strategy. If some corrective actions are to be taken, take those corrective actions. So these are the steps of SHRM. Okay, bye.